After data exploration, next phase is data preprocessing. Remember, the data which you are looking at is readable to you as a human. But when you send that data for machine learning, you have to make it readable and understandable by a machine. And machine only thinks in terms of numbers. It does not understand categorical variables. Variables like we had in our previous data set, like male, female, lunchtime, dinner time. Those kind of categorical variables it does not understand. So as a part of pre-processing, you have to convert it into the numbers. But that's just one piece of pre-processing. You have to do certain other things as part of the pre-processing of your data before you pass it on to machine learning algorithm. So let's begin. We will begin by importing very important libraries. First one, of course, is NumPy as NP, and then don't forget pandas as PD. And let's import seaborn. Very good. Now that you have imported all the important libraries so far, let us first import our data. And it is going to be the same data set you worked on in the previous lecture, the tips data set from SNS library. It's available there, sns.load_dataset, and data set name is tip. And next we are going to create a pandas data frame out of this data set. So pd.dataframe, and of course just put tips here, the data set name. And let's print the header records of this data frame, so that we are sure that we got the data frame ready. Let's run this. Awesome, good job. Data set is ready. As part of pre-processing, the first thing we do is to make sure that there is no null values, like there are no empty values in any of these features or target variables. To do that, let's say df, which is the data frame name, is null, so it will be yes or no, and then sum. It says 000, that means there are no records in this data frame which has no values, so all of them have some value. Very good. If there exists a column which does not have any value, you have to make a decision. How do you fill that column? Like either you put an average number or you just ignore that record. It depends on the case by case. Normally it's not suggested that you ignore that record, but some cases it is not suggested that you populate with the average value. So you have to study the data during data exploration and then decide how do you fill that missing data. And we will do that further down in our project. For now, just remember, there should not be anything null. Let's move on. Next phase is to understand what kind of data you have. Describe your data. And over here, it will show you the statistical analysis of your data, like how many are there, 244 rows are there, the mean of the data, standard deviation, and all other details. Standard deviation 1.3, that means the more or less the data is close by, not very far from each other. This is just tip, right? That the average value of tip is 2.99. But you can get the same kind of analysis, the statistical analysis, for all the variables. Tip is your target variable, but you can also get this analysis for every variable, every features, every target variable in this data frame. And to do that, just say your data frame and then describe. And here you go. Gives you the statistical analysis of all numerical values. Very good, let's move on. And my friend, here comes the real fun. The real data preprocessing starts with a library called SKLbearn. SKLbearn.preprocessing. and from this set of libraries you import the functions you need. So first thing you need to do is convert all these categorical variables into numbers, and for that it's label encoder. Let's see what it does. Label coder df equals label coder. We got the instance, and now let's encode the features. Let's start with sex. Here you see male, female. Let's convert it into a numeric number, which is called encoding. So, and the command for that is label encoder underscore df dot fit underscore transform, and then df and the same one. So df sex column is going to be transformed using label encoder. Let's run this and see the output. Df dot head, and here you go, it changed from male female, it became 0 and 1, and based on this you can say it replaced female with 0 and male with 1. Now the machine learning algorithm can understand this column. Likewise, we can change all other variables. Let's do that. A smoker and a smoker. I understand if you are good in Python, you will understand this too, that instead of just writing each individually, I could use a loop and I could do it easily in just one line command. But I don't want you to get complicated with how better you can do with Python. I don't consider you as a Python expert at this point. That's why I am focusing more on what you can do in machine learning with a very simple commands, even though it is more than one line of command. You can always enhance it further in your real life by using the Python operational tools like loop and all that. Of course, you have to learn Python, but to become a data scientist, you don't have to be expert of the Python. So let's move on. Over here, very good. Now you see all of these variables are replaced with numeric values. It is still data frame, still pandas data frame, and it still holds the same structure, just that the values, the categorical variables, are replaced with numbers. And now your machine algorithm will understand this. This kind of pre-processing you have to do before you decide algorithm. In the previous lecture, when we were talking about heat map, we have seen that the heat map considered only few columns like total tips, total build, tip and size, and it did not consider the categorical variables. Now we have converted those categorical variables into the numerical numbers. Let's create the same heat map now and let's see what happens. Okay, so let's move on, and this time we are going to create our heat map. Same command, r underscore matrix, this is correlation matrix we are creating, equals df dot correlations, and let's create the heat map. Heat map and data equals CORR matrix and not equals true. Very good. And here you go. Now it has all the feature values, right? It has everything. And at this point, if you look at this, you see for tips, total build has the highest number. So the tip is still affected the most by the total build amount. Looks logical to me, because if your total build amount is high, your tip amount will be high, and vice versa. It is affected negatively by the day and time. And after total build, the next variable which affects it most is size. It is affected by sex and smoker also positively, but smoker is the one which is affecting it the least. Next thing, you will split your data between feature values and target variable. Here the target variable is the tip. So let's say target variable name is y, and you are going to have tips in this target variable y. Let's print y dot hit. And here you go, all the tips are there, and rest of the field you will put as a feature. As so, X and just say df, and you are going to drop the target variable x is equals 1. That means you consider all the rows. You are just dropping one of the field, and that is tip, and rest of the data frame you are assigning as a feature variable. So let's understand that, and let's print your x.head. Very good, run this. Awesome. Now you got your x, you got your y, and next you are going to split your complete data into training data and test data. Training data will be used by your data model to train itself so that it can decide the best coefficient or best model to use. And once it has decided best model to use based on the training data, it will use the test data to test that model. If you are getting confused, don't worry, it will become clear when we do the project. But for now, understand, as a data preprocessing step, you are going to split your data into training data and test data. So let's do that. So for splitting your data into training data and test data, you are going to import a class from SKLbearn library again, SKLbearn.modelSelection, import train test split. And you're going to say x train x test y train y test equals train test split x y. And over here, you're going to say the test size, like out of the complete data size, how much you want to put to test, how much you want to put to training. It is up to you, and it is subject to the data. But normally, as a thumb rule, it is seen that people follow 80-20. They put 80% data for the training set and 20% data for the test set. So let's say 0.2. Very good. Let's print it. Let's just print the tape. Save. You don't have to print the complete one. It will not come here. So it's a big one. It's 244 rows, right? So let's just print the shape of the data split. Okay, I think we are good now. Let's run it. Here you go. It split the data into test and train data. For example, the X train has 195 rows and 6 columns. Of course, there one is gone. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and it has 195 rows. Divided the 244 rows into 195 going to training and 49 going to test. Likewise, for the Y train, it has put 195 rows to training and 49 to test. So that is pretty much what you do in data preprocessing. There are further complications, like the label encoder will not be enough. You have to use one hot encoder. Because if you use the label encoder only, then it gives us kind of numbers which can be looked in different ways, right? If you say 0 and 1, you can also say that 0 has higher preference than 1, which is not correct, right? Same way, there might be other data. So to get over such kind of biased analysis or complications which machine learning algorithm might run into, you are going to do one hot encoder. Those are certain things we will do during the project. I don't want to make it over complicated at this point of time. These are basic data processing you do for most of machine learning projects. For now, this is data preprocessing in machine learning for you. Oh, before I go, let me change the name here. Machine learning data preprocessing. Awesome. I will see you in next lecture.